إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون يا أيها الناس اتقوا ربكم الذي خلقكم من نفس واحدة وخلق منها زوجها وبث منهما رجالا كثيرا ونساء واتقوا الله الذي تساءلون به والأرحام إن الله كان عليكم رقيبا يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله وقولوا قولا سديدا يصلح لكم أعمالكم ويغفر لكم ذنوبكم ومن يطع الله ورسوله فقد فاز فوزا عظيما أما بعد فيا معاشر المؤمنين اتقوا الله فإن من اتقى الله وقاه وأرشده إلى خير أمور دينه ودنياه فأوصيكم ونفسي بتقوى الله عز وجل في السر وعلانية. My dear respected brothers, I advise myself first and foremost to fear Allah the Almighty, as the one who does so will be protected by Allah Jalla Jalalu, and Allah will guide him to goodness in all of his affairs, whether it be from the aspects of his religion or the worldly affairs. وَلَقَدْ قَالَ اللَّهُ عَزَّ وَجَلَّ فِي مُحْكَمِ تَنْزِيلِهِ وَلَقَدْ وَصَّيْنَا الَّذِينَ أُوتُوا الْكِتَابَ مِنْ قَبْلِكُمْ وَإِيَّاكُمْ أَنِ اتَّقُوا اللَّهَ. And verily, we have advised to the people, those that came before you, يا معشر الفضلاء, the people of the scripture before you and to you, meaning also to you, we have advised you that you fear Allah Azza wa Jal and keep your duty to Him. So we should all know that fearing Allah Azza wa Jal is not just something that we utter. ليس مجرد التلفظ أو النطق من اللسان. It's not something that we utter from our tongues, but rather it is your duty as a Muslim to act upon that which Allah Azza wa Jal has commanded you with doing, and also leaving off that which He has made unlawful for you. Allah Azza wa Jal is the one that knows all and sees all. So know, O honorable brothers, that sins split into two categories. There are two different types of categories with regards to sins. الأول ترك المأمور وثانيا فعل المحظور. The first one is leaving off the commandments of Allah Azza wa Jal, and the second is doing that which is prohibited. An example is from the first, that Shaytan, Iblis, he left off that which he was commanded. As Allah Azza wa Jal says in the Quran, فَسَجَدُوا إِلَّا إِبْلِيسَ أَبَى وَاسْتَكْبَرَ وَكَانَ مِنَ الْكَافِرِينَ. Iblis, he disobeyed the commandment of Allah Azza wa Jal, that which he commanded him to do so by prostrating to Adam alayhi salam, and therefore he was from the disbelievers. And as for an example of the one that does something that Allah Azza wa Jal has made unlawful, is when Adam alayhi salam disobeyed Allah Azza wa Jal, and he did that which Allah told him not to do so. كَمَا قَالَ اللَّهُ عَزَّ وَجَلْ فِي مُحْكَمِ تَنْزِيلِهِ فَأَكَلَا مِنْهَا فَبَدَتْ لَهُمَا سَوْآتُهُمَا وَطَفِقَا يَخْصِفَانِ عَلَيْهِمَا مِنْ وَرَقِ الْجَنَّةِ وَعَصَى آدَمُ رَبَّهُ فَغَوَى. And of course we know afterwards Adam alayhi salam knew that which he did. ثُمَّ اجْتَبَاهُ رَبُّهُ فَتَابَ عَلَيْهِ وَهَدَى. Then when Allah Azza wa Jal made unlawful for them to eat, meaning Adam and his wife, from the tree, they did so. And in doing so, that which Allah Azza wa Jal has made unlawful, what happened? It caused them to be from those that were abolished from the heavens. So a small reminder, my dear respected brothers, for myself first and foremost, anything that which Allah Azza wa Jal has commanded you to do, from the likes of salah, fasting, siyam, performing hajj, zakah, being dutiful to your parents, or any other actions, then by you leaving it off is a means of you committing sin. وَلِيَعَذُ بِاللَّهِ. And a second type is, if you go to do the things that Allah has made unlawful for you. And there's many of us today, we are literally draining in sins by the likes of committing zina. It is apparent amongst our community, so therefore we should address it and remind ourselves, and our young ones and our loved ones, our children, to leave off that which goes to it. From the likes of going clubbing, from the likes of partying, music, all of these things bring about torment in your life and destruction. So who are you sinning to? And the question many of us, we mention and we say, but it's only a small thing that I'm doing. I'm only committing sin, which is small. I'm not harming anyone. I'm doing something in secret. كما قال النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم إذا لم تستحي فاصنع ما شئت. If you do not have any shame, then do as you please. But verily, you shouldn't say to yourself and think that what I'm doing is small. But rather, you should ask yourself, who am I sinning? Have you no shame? Do you not have any shame in the one that you're sinning to, Jalla Jalalu? It was mentioned that a man came to Imam Ahmad, rahimahullah, and he said, oh Imam, I want to say to you and recite to you and utter to you some lines of poetry. Al-Abiyat al-Shi'riya. So Imam Ahmad responded and said, go ahead. And the man, he responded and he said, إِذَا مَا قَالَ لِي رَبِّي. And listen to these words of poetry. إِذَا مَا قَالَ لِي رَبِّي أَمَسْتَحْيَيْتَ تَعْصِينِي. If my Lord asks me, do you not have any shyness in disobeying me? Do you not, Ya Abdullah, have any shyness when you go towards that sin that you know Allah Azza wa Jal has made unlawful? Do you not have any shyness? And what's even more mind-boggling is that which was said afterwards. وَتُخْفِ الذَّنْبَ عَنْ خَلْقِي وَبِالْعِصْيَانِ تَأْتِينِي وَتُخْفِ الذَّنْبَ عَنْ خَلْقِي وَبِالْعِصْيَانِ تَأْتِينِي. اتَّقُوا اللَّهَ فِي أَنفُسِكُمْ يَا عِبَادَ اللَّهِ. You hide your sins and you conceal them from the people, the creation, the servants of Allah Azza wa Jal. Maybe your friends, you don't want them to know, your household, your family members. But then yet, to Allah Azza wa Jal, you have no shame. So we should remind ourselves to know that sinning is something great. كما قال النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم صلوا عليه كل ابن آدم خطاء وخير الخطائين التوابون رواه الترمذي. That each and every single one of us, I, you and every single one in this world commit sin. But yet the best of you are the ones that what? That make tawbah, that hasten towards making tawbah. So be from those, especially living in these lands where you're surrounded with fitan, with trials and tribulations. There's sins therein for you to even do without you trying. We're doing the khutbah today, we've come for Jum'ah, Allah has blessed us. We hear outside the music that's being played. Don't make this a part of your life. Be from those that represent the deen of Islam. And remember, kullu nafsin dha'iqatu al-maut. Each and every single one of you. You're not guaranteed. You could be young. Maybe you think I'm still in high school. I'm in college. I'm in uni. I'm still enjoying my life. You're not guaranteed that you will be here until tomorrow. قولوا قولي هذا واستغفر الله لي ولكم فاستغفروه إنه هو الغفور الرحيم. بسم الله والحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله. فاللهم اغفر لنا ولوالدينا وللسامعين ولجميع المسلمين أجمعين. يقول الله عز وجل في محكم تنزيله، فاستمعوا إلى هذه الآية. وليست التوبة للذين يعملون السيئات حتى ماذا؟ حتى إذا حضر أحدهم الموت قال إني تبت الآن ولا الذين يموتون وهم كفار أولئك أعتدنا لهم عذابا أليما. So don't be from those that Allah has mentioned in this verse. And remember and know, and of no effect is the repentance of those who, what do? They commit sin and commit sin, and they do evil deeds, and they carry on. Many of us, we fall into this category. We say, I'm Muslim, my name is Muhammad, I'm going to be promised Jannah anyway. So therefore I can do that which I please, that which my desires, my nafs call me to. But no, remember it says here in this verse, they do commit sins day in, day out, until death faces one of them. And they say, now I repent no of those who die while they're disbelievers. For them we have prepared a painful torment. Meaning that the tawbah that they do when Malik al-Maut comes and their appointed time comes to them, they start making tawbah. By then it's what? It's too late. كما قال فرعون. He disbelieved his whole life and he claimed that he was an ilah. But what happened when he realized it was late? It was too late. حتى إذا أدركه الغرق قال آمنت أنه لا إله إلا الذين آمنت به بنو إسرائيل. And then it was too late. وأنا من المسلمين. It was too late. It's too late. When he was being drowned and he was drowning with his companions, then he said, I have believed in that which the message has come. Meaning Musa alayhi salam calling me to worship one Lord and that which Bani Israel have been upon, and now I'm a Muslim. But then it's too late. So remember and know that now the bar, the gate, the door to Tawbah is open. Each and every single one of you here today is flooding in sins. So therefore be from those that hasten to make Tawbah before it's too late. مَادَمْ أَنَّكُمْ تَتَنَفَّسُونَ الْآنِ هَذِهِ نِعْمَةٌ مِنَ اللَّهِ عَزَّ وَجَلَّ فَأَحْمَدُوهُ جَلَّ جَلَالُهُ. Because he's giving you a fursa. As long as you know right now you're able to breathe, you're breathing, which means what Allah Azza wa Jal has blessed you and given you another opportunity. So don't waste it. لا تضيع هذه الفرصة. Because why? Because now remember the hadith كما قال النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم لا ينقطع التوبة حتى تطلع الشمس من مغربها رواه أحمد. That verily the door to Tawbah will not be closed. It will remain open until the sun rises from that which it sets from. So remember and know that right now you have an opportunity to make Tawbah to Allah Azza wa Jal. All of you youth, it's a reminder for myself first and foremost, and all the youth and all the fathers here, remind your youth that within this world that we live in today, no one is guaranteed to make it until 60. How many times do you switch on the TV and you see that a child who's young in age had so much success and future ahead of them, Allah took their soul. So remember and realize and know, stop sinning now, today, whilst you have the opportunity. Make sure that you embrace this beautiful religion, your true identity, and Islam. Stop giving in to those that call you to the roads, those that call you to the hood, to the streets. Don't give in to them, because wallahi, on the day of judgment, they will not benefit you. They will not be a benefit to you, but rather, that which will benefit you is your actions. كما قال النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم يتبع الميت ثلاث أهله وماله وعمله فيبقى واحد ويرجع اثنان يبقى عمله ويرجع أهله وماله. So that which, كما قال النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم, that the disease is followed with three things. His actions, they follow you to your graves. So what have you put forth, Ya Abdullah? Ask yourselves, what have you put forth for this religion? ماذا قدمت لهذا الدين المتين؟ ماذا قدمت؟ من الله عليك بالصحة والعافية والبصر وما إلى غير ذلك. الله عز وجل has blessed you with so many things. With you have eyesight, you're able to breathe, you're able to walk. And people that don't even have a minute of that which you have are striving for the sake of Allah Azza wa Jal. So ask yourselves, you still have sanity, worship Allah Azza wa Jal. What have you put forth? Because that which you put forth will be the only thing that will follow you to your graves. All of those things around you, the popularity, you being famous, your friends, your money, your own mother, your parents, none of them will enter the grave with you. None of them will enter the grave with you. So remember that and make that something that you always remember. وَلَا تَتَّبِعُ خُطُوَاتِ الشَّيْطَانِ. Allah Azza wa Jal is reminding us, don't follow the footsteps of shaytan. And know, Allah, هو الذي يدعوكم إلى الجنة والمغفرة كما قال الله عز وجل. الله يدعو إلى الجنة والمغفرة بإذنه. Allah عز وجل is calling you to the doors of paradise and to forgiveness. He's giving you an opportunity. So make tawbah and don't become متكبر in those things that you have of bad habits which displease Allah عز وجل. Because الكبر, arrogance is that which made shaytan disobey Allah عز وجل. And I'll end on a story. A man came to Ibrahim ibn Adham rahimahullah ta'ala, and he said to him, "Oh Abu Ishaq, verily I have sinned excessively. I'm drowning in sins. Advise me with some sort of admonition. Maybe Allah will guide me and make it of benefit to me." So Abu Ishaq said to him, "I advise you with five things. If you implement them, remember them, then inshallah it will be of benefit to you. And you will leave off that which you're drowning in."
إن أردت أن تعصي الله فلا تأكل رزقه.
That's the first thing.
If you want to disobey Allah and commit sins, then do not eat from His provisions.
So the man replied to Abu Ishaq and said, how can that be when each and everything within this earth is not from Allah's provisions?
And then he said, tell me the second, Ya Abu Ishaq. He said, إن أردت أن تعصي أمره فلا تسكن أرضه ولا تكن مقيما في بلده. If you want to disobey Allah Azza wa Jal from the commandments that He has commanded you to do so, you want to commit sins, then verily don't live within His lands. And don't be a resident within His land, meaning the earth.
So the man responded and he said to him, Ya Abu Ishaq,
how is this possible when that which is from Bayn al-Mashriq wal-Maghrib wal-Furq wa-Madun belongs to Allah? From that which is from the east and earth and up and below belongs to Allah Azza wa Jal.
So the man said, give me the third one.
So he said, إِنْ أَرَبْتَ أَنْ تَأْكُلَ رِزْقَ وَتَسْكُنَ بَلَدَهُ وَتَعْصِيَ أَمْرَهُ فَعْصِيهِ. أي الله عز وجل في مكان لا يطلع عليك فيه.
So he said to him, if you want to eat from Allah's provisions and to live in His lands, and you want to commit sins with doing these two things, i.e. eating from His provision and living in His lands, then verily commit sins. Go and do sins in a place that he will not be able to see.
So the man responded and he said, how is this possible, Ya Abu Ishaq, when he is the all-knower, the all-seer? So then Abu Ishaq responded to him and said, إِذَا أَتَاكَ مَلَكُ الْمَوْتِ فَقُلْ لَهُ أَجِّلْنِي حَتَّى أَتُوبُ إِلَى اللَّهِ عَزَّ وَجَلَّ. He said, Abu Ishaq, if the angel of death comes to you, then verily tell him, delay taking my soul until I repent to Allah Azza wa Jal. And then he said, I cannot do this. I do not have the capability of doing this. So then Abu Ishaq, he said that if you are not thrown into the hellfire by the angels, then resist from entering it and do not obey him. Meaning do not obey them in entering the hellfire for that which you've done in disobeying Allah Azza wa Jal. So the man said, I cannot be able to do this either. I'm not capable of doing such a thing. So then the man responded and said, enough, 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 Ya Abu Ishaq. Enough with the advice. I have now become fatih. I have now realized and grasped that which you tell me. Meaning, it's a reminder to each and every one of you. When you commit sins, remember Allah Azza wa Jal can see you. اُعْبُدُ اللَّهَ كَأَنَّكَ تَرَى فَإِنْ لَمْ تَكُنْ تَرَى فَإِنَّهُ يُرَكَ. And remember and never forget that. Each and every single one of us, we do commit sins. But remember, when you're committing sins, hasten towards At-Tawbah. And don't forget. I remind you, brothers and sisters, إِنَّ اللَّهَ أَمَرَنَا بِأَمْرٍ عَظِيمٍ فَبَدَأَ بِنَفْسِهِ ثُمَّ ثَنَعَ بِهِ مَلَائِكَتَهُ وَقَالَ إِنَّ اللَّهَ وَمَلَائِكَتَهُ يُصَلُّونَ عَلَى النَّبِيِّ يَا أَيُّهَا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا صَلُّوا عَلَيْهِ وَسَلِّمُوا تَسْلِيمًا وصلوا وسلم على مصطفى خير الأفضل أفضل الخلق في الأرض والسماء. اللهم صل على محمد وعلى آل محمد كما صليت على إبراهيم وعلى آل إبراهيم إنك حميد مجيد. اللهم يا مقلب القلوب ثبت قلوبنا على دينك. اللهم يا مصرف القلوب صرف قلوبنا على طاعتك. يا أكرم الأكرمين إنك تقبل التوبة فاغفر لنا ذنوبنا وكفر عنا سيئات أعمالنا يا عزيز يا جبار. سبحان ربك رب العزة عما يصفون وسلام على المرسلين والحمد لله رب العالمين. أقوم إلى صلاتكم يرحمكم الله.